Yeah, go for it.
Inside this fifth grade science classroom, Maggie Breach is giving her students wings, but they need to be patient to see them.
We're measuring this monarch larva caterpillar to see how long it is.
Using technology and time,
probably like 2 centimeters.
These students are tracking the life cycle of a monarch butterfly. Right now, it's just a caterpillar.
My question is, what is it doing?
It's going through something called instar, which is a stage in the life of an insect between molts.
No, it's the third instar because the stripes are more distinct.
And this morning when I came in, the caterpillar, what shape were we looking for? Do you remember the shape? The J.
That's something the caterpillar does just before it enters its next stage.
And it formed the pupa, and it's now forming the chrysalis. Okay, so it's so exciting. The word you were going to learn today was pupate, because we were waiting for the caterpillar to pupate. And it just did.
Well, the chrysalis is after the fifth instar when it's getting ready to form into a butterfly.
Which is exactly what happened in Maggie's class.
This one does not have spots, which means it is a female.
The journey from caterpillar to butterfly takes about 4 weeks, but there's another long trip that this one is about to take off on.
You all are actually going to help tag the butterfly.
The butterfly is tagged and data is collected before being released on its migratory track to Mexico.
Hang on. Okay, give me your hand. Okay, so come here. Okay, so. I mean, think about it. It went from being like in a caterpillar to a chrysalis. Now it has wings.
If found, researchers can see she came from Milton Hershey School.